Saturday, September 22, 1883. Sri Ramakrishna was seated in the drawing room of Adhar's house in Calcutta. Vidrakhal, Adhar, M, Ishan, and other devotees. Many gentlemen of the neighborhood were also present. It was afternoon. The master was very fond of Ishan. He had been a superintendent in the accountant general's office, and later on, his children also occupied high government positions. One of them was a classmate of Narendra. Ishan's purse was always open for the poor and needy. When he retired from service, he devoted his time to spiritual practices and charity. He often visited Sri Ramakrishna at Dakshineshwar. Master to Ishan. Please tell us the story of the boy who posted the letter. Ishan, with a smile. A boy once heard that God is our creator. So, he wrote a letter to God, setting forth his prayers, and posted it. The address he put on the envelope was heaven. Master, with a smile. Did you hear that story? One succeeds in spiritual life when one develops a faith like that boy's. To Ishan. Tell us about the renunciation of activities. Ishan. After the attainment of God, religious duties such as the sandhya drop away. One day, some people were sitting on the bank of the Ganges performing the sandhya. But one of them abstained from it. On being asked the reason, he said, I am observing Ashaucha. I cannot perform the sandhya ceremony. Footnote. Ashaucha. Ashaucha is a temporary defilement caused by the birth or death of a blood relative. A man observing Ashaucha cannot perform the sandhya or daily worship. Footnote ends. In my case, the defilement is due to both a birth and a death. My mother, ignorance, is dead. And my son, self-knowledge, has been born. Master, tell us also how caste distinctions drop away when one attains self-knowledge. Ishan, Shankaracharya was once climbing the steps after finishing his bath in the Ganges. When he saw just in front of him an untouchable who had a pack of dogs with him. You have touched me, said Shankara. Revered sir, said the pariah, I have not touched you, nor have you touched me. The self is the inner ruler of all beings and cannot be contaminated. Is there any difference between the sun's reflection in wine and its reflection in the Ganges? Master, with a smile. And about harmony? How one can realize God through all paths? Ishan, smiling. Both Hari and Hara are derived from the same root. Footnote. The root Hri, from which both words are derived. Further, Hari and Hara are two manifestations of the same Godhead. Hari is the name of Vishnu, the ideal deity of the Vaishnavas, and Hara, a name of Shiva, the ideal deity of the Shaivas. Footnote ends. The difference is only in the Pratyaya. Footnote. Pratyaya. There is a pun on this word, which means both faith and inflection. Footnote ends. In reality, he who is Hari is also Hara. If a man has faith in God, then it doesn't matter whom he worships. Master, and please tell us also how the heart of the sadhu is the greatest of all. Ishan, this earth is the largest thing we see anywhere around us. But larger than the earth is the ocean. And larger than the ocean is the sky. But Vishnu, the Godhead, has covered earth, sky, and the netherworld with one of his feet. And that foot of Vishnu is enshrined in the sadhu's heart. Therefore, the heart of a holy man is the greatest of all. The devotees were delighted with Ishan's words.